So we shall see some examples regarding the laws ambazo tuliziona to conclude this part vizuri. So the temperature of the furnace is 2324 degrees centigrade, and the intensity is maximum in its radiation spectrum nearly 1200, 1000, I mean 12,000 angstrom. If the intensity in the spectrum of a star is maximum, nearly 4800 angstrom, then calculate the surface temperature of the star. So we have two issues here. We have a furnace, okay, and we have a star. So we are comparing the two. So according to Wien's displacement law, inatuambia product ya wavelength maximum na absolute temperature is a constant. So that means for maximum 1 times temperature 1 ni sawasawa na maximum 2 times temperature 2 sawasawa na maximum 3 as many as infinity. So from here we can make T2 the subject. So it's either we assume kwamba hizi ni za furnace, then the second one hizi 2 ni ya star. So it means if we want the temperature 2, it's here T2 ni sawasawa na T1 times wavelength 1 divided by wavelength 2. So remember ni absolute temperatures, so you should add 273. Absolute temperatures, so you should add 273. Always in absolute temperature. So T1 ukiongeza 273 unapata 2597 Kelvin. Na similarly, easy angstrom you convert them into meters, which ni una angstrom ni 10 power negative 10. Anyway, kwa vile ni ratio, so zitaji cancel tu, zenye hamna haja ya kuconvert. So then you can put temperature 1 ambayo ipo in Kelvin 2597 times wavelength 1 ambayo tulisema hizi 1 ni za furnace ambayo maximum temperature ya furnace ni hiyo, na radiation spectrum wavelength ni 12. You put hapo divide by wavelength maximum 2 ambazo tulisema ni za star ambayo ina 4800 angstrom. You put in the numbers and you get temperature ya the star ni 6492.5 Kelvin. Okay, amua kwa kwa degree centigrade ni 6219.5 degrees centigrade. So Wien's law usually has simple questions. And we have a question here that we shall solve kulingana na Stefan's law. We have a small hole which is made of a hollow sphere. Okay, a small hole which is made in a hollow sphere, whose walls are at 723 degrees centigrade. Find the total energy radiated per second per centimeter. So it's just simple. We know that Stefan's law inasema power. Remember, find the energy radiated per second, which is power. Ni sawasawa na area, surface area, times Stefan's constant, times the emissivity, times T power 4. So the energy that is radiated, you remember area in a sphere, so surface area ni 4 pi r squared. Pi r squared times Stefan's constant, emissivity T power 4. So it's what they have done here. However, the question inatuambia find the total energy radiated per second per centimeter squared. It means hii area ipo tayari kwenye what we are asked to find. So tuseme energy radiated per second ni power. Power lakini per area. Kwa tuseme what they are asking ni power per area. So this is equal to Stefan's constant times emissivity times T power 4. So we have the Stefan's constant. We have the temperature converted into Kelvin hapo. Remember ni absolute temperature. We have the Stefan constant. Ingawa na units za ajabu, eggs na centimeter squared, but our focus is the how to solve the question. So Stefan's constant unayo, temperature unayo, emissivity for cases kama hizi ambazo they don't tell you, usually it is safe to assume kwamba ni one, okay, especially when it is a hollow sphere and all the stuff. So it is just safe to assume hii emissivity kwamba is just one, though it is very important wakakwambia. Na sometimes kama hauna, it's better you leave it na expression ikiwa na e kama e, hivyo hivyo emissivity. But otherwise you are sure, you can state kwamba assuming ni one, then you put in the numbers and unapata solution. So as usual tuangalie when they are somehow they are complicated kidogo zikiongezewa uzito tuone zinakuwaje because sometimes questions don't come straightforward. So we have a question: calculate the temperature in Kelvin at which a perfect black body radiates at a rate of 5.67 watts per centimeter squared. Okay, hiyo ni power per area. So calculate the temperature in Kelvin. So again we just simply know the formula inatuambia. Remember, huku wanapenda kutumia sana E, but E ni energy per second. It's not just energy, ni energy per second. It's very important kwa sababu we shall see somewhere they ask you to find the energy, not energy per second. So don't confuse. So for this case, ukiona hizi E, they mean energy per second. Sio energy kama energy. So if we want energy per area ambayo ndo tumepewa hapa at a rate of 5.67 watts per centimeter squared. It means ile area tayari iko combined kwenye area power kama the previous example. So tunabaki tuna Stefan's constant na temperature na E tulisema it is safe to assume cause especially hapa ambapo amekwambia kabisa ni perfect black body. It means E ni sawa na 1. Okay? Emissivity ni sawa na 1. So unabaki na Stefan's constant na temperature. So it's just simple. Umepewa hii value ya hii huku ambayo ni 5.67 una divide na Stefan's constant ambayo umepewa 5.67 unapata hiyo then unatafuta the cube the fourth root ya hiyo division then you get your answer in 1000 Kelvin. So you have another one. Due to change in the mains voltage, the temperature of electric bulb rises from 3000 to 4000. What is the percentage rise in electrical power consumed? Okay, what is the percentage rise in electrical power consumed? So we know that power at the first condition, at first case, power ni sawa sana Stefan's constant. So power per area. Okay, they are not giving us the area, so it is just safe to assume kwamba power per area. Okay, power per area ni sawa sawa na Stefan's constant, so like the other cases too, watts per centimeter squared. So we have Stefan's constant ambayo tujapewa na temperature ya kwanza ambayo ilikuwa 3000. Then kwenye second case tuna Stefan's constant na temperature ya pili ambayo ni 4000 hiyo. So we have this power consumed at second case na this power consumed at the first case. So kwa mfano hapa ametafuta ratio between P2 na P1. Akapata ratio ni hii hapa. Okay? So it is just simple to assume kwamba the percentage rise of power, the percentage rise you can see the difference between the ratio ya huyo na huyo. Kwa ukichukua 256 minus 81 unapata 175. Amefanya hivyo but there is another way ambayo you can just go around it. So unapata 175 percentage rise. Percentage rise unaangalia kilichoongezeka compared to ile ya first case. Okay, kilichoongezeka compared to ile first case. You see P1 ilikuwa ni 81. So kuna a rise of 175 units as compared to the first case ambayo ilikuwa ni 81 times 100 unapata 216. In other ways, you can just simply do this. Okay, you can just simply do this. You can you see ukiangalia hapa na hapa, so you can find the difference between power 1 because percentage rise hapo itakuwa ni power in the second case minus power in the first case divide by the initial ambayo ilikuwepo times 100. Okay, times 100. So if you take power in the second case which is 4 power 4 times 10 power 12 Stefan's constant here, so everything is common except these two. So ni 4 power 4, 4 power 4 minus 3 power 4. Okay, kwa sababu hii 10 power 12 na Stefan's constant zitakuwa common, udai factor out nje, so we can assume hizo ni constants divide by P1, P1 ambayo ilikuwa ni 3 power 4. Again Stefan's constant na hizo we can just simplify tukasema ni constant times 100. Nimefanya hivi kwa sababu eventually they will just cancel. Okay, they will eventually cancel. So here you have 4 power 4 minus 3 power 4 divided by 3 power 4 times 100. So you solve this, you get the answer is here. So another question is, consider the sun as a perfect sphere of radius here. Calculate the energy radiated by sun in 1 minute and surface temperature of sun is that. Na Stefan's question, just straightforward questions. We know that power, because this is now, because mwana sasa hapa, umuimwa ile kuwa power and not just energy. Remember, calculate the energy radiated by the sun in 1 minute. Okay, so first we find power to put energy in 1 second. Then we can calculate energy in 1 minute. So tunajua power is given by Stefan's constant, emissivity, na surface area times temperature, absolute power 4. Simple. You put in the numbers, surface area in a sphere, radius umepewa, surface area sphere in 4 pi r squared. You put in the numbers, you get the surface area, Stefan's constant umepewa. This is the sun, ni perfect black body, hii ni sawa sawa na 1. Absolute temperature umepewa 6200 power 4. You put in the numbers, na jibu utakao lipata utapata power, una multiply by 1 minute ni 60 seconds. So una multiply by 60 seconds, as you can see 1 minute ni 60 seconds, and you can see hapa ame multiply 60. Then the answer you get inakuwa in joule. Simple. Another question, you have an electric bulb with tungsten filament having an area you hapo raised to temperature 2727 degrees centigrade when current passes through it. Calculate the electric power being consumed in what if the emissivity of filament is 0.35. Stefan's constant umepewa you hapo. So again, kuna two scenarios kama the first case. Area umepewa, you convert it of course kwenye meters squared. Now multiply times 10 power negative 4. Temperature umepewa, convert it to Kelvin, hiyo hapo. Stefan's constant umepewa hiyo hapo. Egg, of course, ameconvert hiyo kwenye joule, hizo kwenye SI units. So multiply 2 times 10 power negative 3, inakuwa inaconvert kwenye joules, meter squared, meter power negative 2, seconds power negative 1, Kelvin power negative 4. So the area inatuambia kwamba area, surface area, the power, ni sasa surface area times emissivity times Stefan's constant times absolute temperature power 4. So we have all these. Okay, and we get our answer. That simple. Come on. We have another question. An indirectly heated filament is radiating maximum energy of wavelength here up. Find the net amount of heat energy lost per second per unit area, the temperature surrounding air umepewa here up. So umepewa B ni hiyo hapo, na umepewa Stefan's constant ni hiyo. B, hii B, as you can see, imeandikwa centimeter Kelvin. Hii ni ile constant ya Wien's displacement law. So, kwenye ile formula yetu kwamba product ya wavelength na absolute temperature ni sawa sawa na constant ya mbondo hiyo B. As you can see, centimeter for this wavelength na Kelvin for this temperature. So if we have B, hapa tumepewa wavelength, then we can calculate the temperature ya filament. Okay, tuweza tukakalculate temperature ya filament. Then hapa sasa ndo inatumika ile concept ya Prevost law ya heat exchange. Kwamba we have the surrounding air ambayo ina temperature yake na tuna temperature ya the filament. So simply formula yetu inakuwa ni kama hichi kilichoandikwa hapa, kwamba power au radiation lost ni sawa sawa na area, Stefan's constant na times temperature ya body minus temperature surrounding. Kwa kutumia hapa tutapata temperature ya body, tutaweka, kumbuka iwe absolute, na hii 13 degrees centigrade tukakombete kwenye absolute, tutaweka in the other side, then tutazisubtract, tuta multiply na Stefan's constant na surface area. Anyway, hapo we can assume tu kwamba the surface area is 1. Okay, but anyway, kwa sababu ni 1, kwa sababu wameshasema kwamba utafute amount of heat energy lost per second per unit area. So hii area inakuja tu inakuwa tayari ipo kwenye hichi tunachotafuta area na hapa area. So area inakuwa ni 1 sababu tayari umeshaambiwa per unit area na umeshaambiwa per unit second, kwa hiyo inakuwa the answer ya this difference una multiply na Stefan's constant and get the answer. Hivyo this is where I was telling you kwamba Stefan's constant sometimes ukitumia concept ya Prevost you can get now formula twist kidogo ikawa ina hizi hichi kitu hapa. As you can see temperature surrounding air maana yake the body will be absorbing na temperature yake the body kama body it will be losing heat, kwa there is a net effect between absorbing na emission. So you are supposed to find the net amount of heat energy lost. So we have a black body that is placed in an enclosure whose walls are blackened and kept at that. Compare the rate at which heat is gained or lost by the body when its temperature is that na temperature is that. Same, tunatumia this concept. Still the same. Okay, still the same. Only that when you compare, maana yake you find the ratio. Okay, you find the ratio. Ndio maana comparison. So kwenye first case, temperature ya body ni 27. Ya surrounding, imewekwa kwenye enclosure and black and kept at you hapo. Compare that body when the temperature is okay. Kwa ipo kwenye enclosure ambayo enclosure ni 27. Kwa first case ni 27 na mia 27. As you can see hapa 27 ameconvert kwenye Kelvin na mia 27 umepata that answer. Okay? Na kwenye second case una compare 27 na negative 73, so you can see wana convert kwenye Kelvin. Kwa okay, uki add it, una add it to 73. Kwa sasa 73 minus 73. Una convert kwenye Kelvin. Kwa inakuwa 200. So you get here. So you can compare the ratio between the first and the second case. A blackened metal container of negligible heat capacity is filled with water. The container is cubical with each side 5 cm long. It is placed in an evacuated enclosure whose walls are kept here. In what time will the water temperature change from 30 degrees centigrade to 29 degrees centigrade? This is how Newton's law of cooling ina apply. Okay? Tuna apply Stefan's law, tuna apply concept ya Prevost, tuna apply Newton's laws of cooling. Okay? So the question inatuambia in what time will the water temperature change from 30 degrees centigrade to 29 degrees centigrade. So if I take you back to the Newton's law of cooling, okay, if I take you back to Newton's law of cooling, tulisema kwamba you remember kuna ile formula ambayo ilikuwa inatumia mass na specific heat capacity times change in temperature. Okay, unapata heat lost kutoka sasa na unaachana na hii part ya kwanza, tuna deal na hii part ya cooling. Okay, kutoka 30 kwenda 29. So unakumbuka kabisa nilikuonesha formula ambayo ilikuwa inasema MC times change in temperature. You remember this very well, right? Yes, kwamba hii ni heat lost, heat lost. So heat lost in water by water in cooling from that to that inakuwa ni hiyo. So the concept ni kwamba a blackened metal container hii hapa ambayo heat capacity yake ni negligible inakuwa filled with water. It is important so that we neglect the effect of the metal container na to deal na maji tu kama maji. The container is cubical na hiyo, so it is placed in evacuated enclosure whose walls are kept at 27. So at what time kuna heat exchange between the water na hiyo enclosure. Okay, ambayo inasababisha haya maji ya cool. Kwa kuna heat lost hapo. So heat lost kutokana na ile formula yetu ambayo nilikuambia mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. Tunapata mass, okay? Mass of water tunaipataje? Tunaipata kwa sababu tuna density ya water na tumeambiwa ni cube, so we can get the volume of the cube. Volume of the cube ni sawa na length times width times height. So tuna both sides ni 5 5 5. So 5 times 5 times 5 hiyo ni volume ya hiyo cube, okay, times density ambayo ni 1 gram per centimeter cube, unapata mass ni 125 grams mass ya water. So if you put mass ya water, specific capacity ya water inajulikana, ambayo ni hii hapa wameiweka hapo, hawajakupa but it is known, it's a constant. Na change in temperature kutoka 30 mpaka 29 ipo hapo, so you can just put 125, okay, 125 ambao ni mass times specific heat capacity of water ambao ni 1 na times the temperature difference ambao ni 30 minus 29 unapata 125 calories. Hiyo wamekupa temperature equivalent ili convert joules kwenye calories. Okay, kusaidia convert joules kwenda kwenye calories. So kwa sababu hapa tumepewa calories na specific heat capacity ni 1 lakini ikiwa kwenye units za calories, na ndio maana tumepata hapa the answer ikiwa in calories, so we can use this to convert kwamba 4.2 joules ni in 1 calorie. So 125 calories ni how many joules? So you just take 125 times 4.2 na unapata joules. Okay, you can see kwamba 125 times 4.2 unapata joules. So the amount of heat lost ni 125 times 4.2 joules. Okay, but temperature lost, but power lost ni sawasawa na, tunarudi kwenye formula yetu sasa, Prevost exchange na Stefan's law inatuambia power ni sawasawa na area times Stefan's constant times emissivity, lakini wamesema ni black and metal container, so we are safe to assume kwamba E ni 1 times temperature change kwa sababu iko kwenye enclosure. Prevost sasa, maji yale na temperature yake na enclosure ambayo hayo maji yamewekwa ndani ya temperature, kwa hiyo unatokea na temperature change according to Prevost law. So you remember kati tunafundisha Newton's law, niliwaambia kwamba if there is a change in temperature from one point to another, temperature hiyo body ni average ya hiyo change. So kutoka 30 mpaka 29 temperature ya maji yale ni 30 plus 29 divided by 2 ni average temperature, ndio tunachukua ni temperature ya yale maji. So one of the temperatures zitakuwa ni average, as you can see mean temperature of the water ni 30 plus 29 divided by 2 tunapata temperature. So one of the temperatures hapa ni temperature ya body na the other temperature ni temperature surrounding. So tunapata hapo the power lost. So we have the area because we know ile ni cubical container. So the surface area ni 6 times 5 times 5 times 5. Sio? So inakuwa ni the area ni 6 times 5 surface area. So si side zote times 5. Okay? Because we have one square, so ziko 6 sides. Kwa surface area total inakuwa hiyo hapo. Times Stefan's constant ambao umepewa hii hapa 5.67 times 10 to negative 8 kwa Stefan's constant times una convert temperature kwenye Kelvin ambao ni hapa power 4, una convert temperature kwenye Kelvin ambao kiadi 273 inakuwa ni 300 Kelvin. Kwa 302.5 power 4 minus 300 Kelvin tunapata kile kitu cha hapa. So what you will get hapa ni power. Okay, but power ni energy divided by time. Energy divided by time. So to get time ambayo itatoka kutoka hapo mpaka hapo ni sawa sawa na time ni sawa sawa na energy divided by power. Where is the energy? Energy is what we are doing hapa. Okay, forgot njia ambayo alikuwa anaiongelea huyo. Ame simplify it to combine. But you remember the energy ilikuwa ni 1.125 calories. So you take 125 calories divide by the power ambao umepata kwenye calculation hapa ambacho is what amlikuwa anajaribu kufanya hapa, then you can get the time na whatever. So you can see the question is not that straightforward, inahitaji kidogo ufikirie. So we have a 100 watt electric bulb which has a filament of 0.6 meters long and diameter of 8 times 10 power negative 5 meters. Estimate working temperature filament emissivity umepewa hiyo hapo. It's just simple. Power ni sawa sawa na area emissivity Stefan's constant T power 4. So T power 4 ni sawa sawa na power surface area emissivity Stefan's constant. So we have power 100. The surface area of a cylinder ni pi dh, okay, an open cylinder. Our assumption kwamba hii ni sawa sawa na open cylinder. So tunavyopewa surface area ni pi dh, kwa hiyo tunaweka pi, tunaweka diameter, tunaweka length 0.6, tunapata surface area ni hapo. Emissivity tumepewa ni 0.7, Stefan's constant 5.7 times 10 power negative 8. So we put in the numbers na tunapata jibu too easily. tafuta fourth root ya hiyo, unapata jibu. So other questions na kuachia tu ufanye mwenyewe. Sidhani kama kuna swali ambalo linaweza likakushinda. All these questions are just simple. You can see. So may you please solve these questions. I believe by now hamna swali ambalo litakushinda. Na haya yote for your practice, you can just solve this for your practice. So you remember B ni Stefan's constant. I mean Wien's displacement constant, ile constant. So ukiona hivyo usishangae. So they are easy. You can solve na unaona kuna majibu for your practice.